I'm in Venice Beach, California, at the studio of Greg Falk, the co-founder of Carver, where we're going to have a conversation about Carver CX bushings. And I wanted to do this video, Greg, because when Riptide recently came out with new CX bushings that are the right size, and when they did, there was a lot of conversations that came out on the online forums, and I've seen that there's quite a bit of misinformation out there about the CX bushings, and so I wanted to go straight to the source and make sure that people have the right information on if they're going to upgrade and customize their CX with some aftermarket bushings. What are the guidelines? What do we need to know about that? But before we get into that, can you just tell us a little bit about who you are and your role at Carver?
My name is Greg Falk, and I'm the co-founder of Carver. My focus currently is Kaizen. I'm in charge of improving our products. So I listen to our customers, and I, you know, see what works in our existing products. And you know, apply that knowledge to make changes that improve the experience of riding a Carver.
So Greg, I brought a number of aftermarket bushings with me, and I brought some that I think are pretty popular out there that people use for the CX. We've got some Venoms, some Riptides, some Orangutans, and some Sabres from the UK. And so when it comes to people choosing aftermarket bushings for the CX, what's the number one most important thing they need to know?
The most important thing in choosing a bushing is the size of the bushing, the height of the bushing. Durometer is a personal choice, but the size of the bushing is critical to the performance of the CX. If you put in the wrong bushing, you can get wheel bite, you can get breakage, you can get a whole bunch of bad issues that will arise from that. The geometry of the CX truck is very deliberate. There's no surprises here. And there's two bushings that go into the making of the CX truck, the 6.5 and the 5.6. They're almost the same height, right? There may be a quarter thickness is the difference, right? So it's very common that people confuse these, but what's critical is to put the tall one, the 6.5 on the bottom and the 5.6 on the top. If you invert them, look what happens. When you put the small bushing on the bottom, and you put the hanger back on, you're actually hitting the D-hole. You see how that hanger now is riding in the D-hole? And that's what causes breakage. If you put too tall of a bushing in there, then it sits on the other side of the D-hole. So it's really critical that it sits right in the middle. I'll show you how it's designed to sit. This is the proper bushing in there, 6.5. And you'll see it sits right in the middle of the D-hole. You see how it's in the center of the D-hole there? But if I put this other bushing in, you know, and if this is the bushing that we sell, it's dangerously close to it, right? It sits in the same place. If you put this one in there, now you see where it's sitting, right? You're actually riding.
Greg, you just showed us how it's critical to have the right board side measurement, that 0.65. How important is it to have the right roadside bushing? Does that matter?
Roadside bushing matters as well. For example, if you have too tall of a bushing, you're not able to engage the nylock in your lock nut, and it vibrates off while riding. Gravity's pulling it off, your rotation's turning it off. If it's too short, you have your kingpin protruding with all the threads exposed. Also not ideal. The street side is critical, board side more critical, but both, you know, are critical to the performance of the
So here's an example of using the wrong size bushing on the street side. It's the right size bushing on the board side, everything's right there, but the street side is wrong. You can see that you have all of these threads protruding from your truck. If you were to get rid of those threads, then you get damage. Your truck has no resistance in it. So it's really critical that when you tighten down your kingpin nut, that you have a preload of tension in your hanger. So this is what happens when your street side bushing is too tall. There's not enough threads there, and when you engage the nut, your nylock is not engaged, right? And so then when you ride your skate, it vibrates off. So it's critical that you have the right size bushing on the street side as well.
Greg, you guys offer two sets of your bushings. One is a looser set, one is a firm set. Can you tell us the differences between those, why it matters, and maybe recommendations for different riders of how to choose between the loose versus the firm Carver set?
That's correct. Carver makes two different bushing sets. We make our standard bushing set, which are both conical, top and bottom, 5.6 and 6.5. And then we make a barrel bushing, which is the same durometer, but because of the shape of it, it has more mass
and therefore creates more resistance. And so that's our firm setting.
So on the firm setting, you have the barrel on the board side and correct. The cone on the road side.
Exactly. What the barrel and the firmer setting is for is larger people, big football player guys that need a lot of resistance, and people who prefer a very tight setting. While our standard setting and most of our boards, you know, come with the conical, and that's what most of our customers prefer. And, you know, we're looking to even put out new bushings that are yet softer. So softer bushings seem to be very popular right now. So that's our next plan. That's our next move.
So when it comes to customizing, anybody can use barrel bushings for that board side as long as it's the right size, 0.65.
Correct.
And would you recommend barrels for roadside? Can you go barrel?
Some people do. You know, a conical bushing, because of the shape of it, when you exert force against it, there's kind of a exponential feel. You get there's no resistance to it. Whereas when you exert force on a barrel, because of the increased mass, you have a stable bottom to it. And so they just have very, very different feels.
Is there a reason why the CX comes standard with cone?
Because that's what our riders prefer. And that's even affirmed by the fact that the newest surf skaters want yet softer bushings, right? And so that's the trajectory. People want more surf in their skate, you know? And so we're listening and delivering.
So the point is, cone gives you a wider range of motion, less resistance. And a barrel will give you more rebound, better for maybe your heavier weights and if you just want a stiffer feel.
I would say a conical bushing gives you more rebound, more bounce, more responsiveness, which you would want, you know, traditional surf skating. Maybe if you're bull riding and doing a long extended turn, you prefer a barrel that's not pushing back. It's not as snappy and move, you know, it's more stable. So it probably depends on the type of riding that you're doing.
Another question I wanted to ask Greg was the difference between cup washers and flat washers. Your CX comes standard with cup washers. Is there a reason for that? Can people use flat washers? What's the difference between them?
You probably can use either cup washers or flat washers as long as they're the right thickness. We prefer cup washers because they actually contain the urethane. They literally cup the urethane. If you had a flat washer, you wouldn't have as much control over, you know, deflection and, you know, spill out from the bottom. So we prefer cup washers.
What's the effect of changing out from a cup washer to a flat washer?
I don't know that there'd be a net effect. I just know that if the objective is to use the urethane with the spec durometer and size, that holding with the cup washer would have a better chance of, you know, perpetuating and retaining that and, you know, giving the feel that was desired.
Is there anything else you want us to know about Carver CX bushings or just the Carver CX in general so that people are making sure that they're riding these correctly, using them correctly, not having breakage, and that they're performing correctly?
At Carver, we effort to make the best bushing available. We spare no expense. Our objective is to deliver on the best quality bushing available, highest rebound, durability, all the qualities we seek in a bushing. If we could make a better bushing, we would. And we're working on bushings as we speak. That's our intention. So, you know, if you want to modify it aftermarket for different durometers, you know, we encourage you to explore and make sure you have the right size. It's critical that the sizes are there.
Greg, I really appreciate your time and expertise. Thanks so much for taking the time out of your life to share this with us. And I hope you find this helpful as you are upgrading and customizing your CX.